they need to use a certain percentage of recycled materials, and those recycled materials could come from black mass. So it's really about creating circularity in the UK for battery materials.
Hello, you're watching Proactive. I'm joined by Technology Minerals CEO Alex Stanbury. Alex, very good to speak with you. You've announced that Recyclus has successfully secured a transfrontier shipment of waste approval as to sell black mass to Glencore under the offtake agreement you signed back in December. Can you tell us what a TFS is and the significance of this to Recyclus?
Yeah, so when we take batteries in, that they are they're not deemed as hazardous waste in the UK, but once they've been processed, the material at the back end, the black mass, which contains the nickel, the cobalt, the lithium, and manganese, is then designated as hazardous waste. So in order to ship it across borders, we need something called a transfrontier shipment notice. And that's essentially the Environment Agency contacting each of the corresponding agencies and the in the countries through which this material travels to its end destination, all of whom need to approve the transport of this material to its to the place where it goes to be processed. So it's not the shortest of pieces of work. And as our shareholders know, there was a false start when we looked to ship it to another offtaker that had complications with between the two agencies. So we are very happy that finally we've got the notification we require in order to be able to sell the black mass.
Can you tell us more about what black mass is and why it's in such demand?
So black mass is the material that comes off the cathode. So it's given its color by the graphite, but the value in it sits within the lithium, the cobalt, and the nickel. That's often NMC cathode batteries, which are the more valuable batteries. These are deemed to be critical materials, and they're required for the process, the manufacture of new batteries. So when you're trying to create circularity, rather than look for newly mined lithium, nickel, cobalt, you really want to try and be reusing the materials that have got to the end of life. That way, you're reducing the upstream requirements and the need for virgin extractions. So if you like, it's a kind of urban mining. Now in the UK, we have very little in the way of critical material mining. So urban mining really is the source of raw material going forward for battery manufacturers. And battery manufacturing is a burgeoning sector in the UK. We've got AESC in the north, and then we've got Agratas coming into Somerset with a 40 gigawatt hour plant next year. And they're going to require a lot of raw material. And in terms of reaching and meeting their mandated targets for 2030, they need to use certain percentages of recycled materials. And those recycled materials could come from black mass. So it's really about creating circularity in the UK for battery materials.
Alex, this news comes on the back of good momentum with other new customer announcements this year for the company. Can you tell us a bit more about your start to the year?
Sure. Yeah, we started this year off to a good start. Really, it's been a fast start. Well, a lot of these things we've been working on for quite a while, but they've really come to fruition at the in the last month or so. So we were working with a major automotive last year, and we started doing more work with them this year as well. And then we had a major electronics company. Consumer goods, and we've done about 4,000 batteries for them now as well. Yeah, there are various other contracts we're working on at this time, but the really sort of things that have taken a long time in gestation are really coming to fruition now and giving us a very solid start to the year.
Recyclus has always worked closely with academia and government to further developments into battery recycling technologies. Do you have any updates on that for us?
Yeah, we are. And so I think the first model for our business was always to be able to take any shape, size, form of lithium ion battery, process it, and create black mass. And that creates a saleable commodity in black mass and also the other fractions. The next part of our development really is to look at creating that circularity I was talking about within the UK. And so we are working with academia and a potential joint venture partner who we already signed an MOU with to create that next stage, which is black mass separation in the UK. So yeah, that's really the next stage. is making sure that all the materials that we produce stay in the UK and end up going into battery manufacturing. We also continue to work on our mobile solution as well.
Okay, so good start to the year, and no doubt you'll be looking to continue that, Alex.
Of course, there's always a lot on a lot of work, and I think as the supply of batteries ramps up in the UK, as all of your consumer goods go from using alkaline into lithium ion, that sub-industrial piece of business continues to grow. But really, for us, the focus and the driving force is beyond that baseline, is really into the automotive side, because as you can imagine, an automotive battery can be 300 kilos up to 1.2 tons. That takes an awful lot of toothbrush batteries to create that sort of weight. So it's really working with major automotive energy storage companies as well, and sort of dealing with their end of life, their warranty recalls, and being the one point of contact solution for them, so they can focus on what they want to do, which is selling cars, and we can focus on the problem side of it for them.
Alex, I hope you'll keep us posted on any progress with that. Thank you very much for the update today.
Pleasure. Good to see you, Stephen. Thank you for having me.
And yours, a pleasure. Alex Stanbury, the CEO of Technology Minerals.